In this mini video lecture, I'm going to talk about the journey of the C programming language from its early days in 1972 to the latest developments in 2011 and 2018. So in 1972, Dennis Ritchie started to work on the improvement of a language called as B. So B was being developed by a gentleman called as Ken Thompson. And the major features of B, or a lot of development aspects of the B language, were derived from a language called as BCPL by a gentleman called as Martin Richards. So BCPL stands for Basic Combined Programming Language. So the name C is not something special, because Dennis Ritchie started to work on improving B. The next alphabet he saw was C, so he gave it the name C. Now if you remember, a lot of these developments were related to work on the Unix operating system as well as on the hardware machine called as the PDP-11, which we discussed during the generation of computer hardware development. The result of the work of Dennis Ritchie of trying to work on improving the B language turned out to be the C programming language. The most important aspect of the development of the C programming language in those days was writing the internal parts or the kernel of the operating system or the major portions of the operating system using the newly developed C language. Because before that, it was mostly assembly language which was used for writing the low-level operating system features. So it was one of the earliest language, or in fact the first language, which used a high-level programming language in place of assembly language for writing the internal or low-level parts of the operating system. As a result of its features, the language became extremely popular and began to be used in the universities as well as the industries. Now, as a result of its popularity, in 1978, in order to discuss what was possible or what are the aspects or features of the C language, Kernighan and Ritchie released the first specification or the first version of the book called as the C programming language. It detailed what are the features of this language, what all is possible to be done by this language, and so on. Now the problem with C was, in the early days of 75-80, lot of unofficial and changes to the original C began to circulate. In the sense, for example, I made my own additions to how C can do certain things. So say for example, Graphic Era University version of C was slightly different from the Graphic Era Hill University version of C. Now you can think of hundreds and thousands of places C being used, and with all the unofficial versions, something which could run on place X may not run on place Y, because the compiler which was used in place X would not support the features of compilers which were supported by or which were allowing things in place Y. So the compilers being used in one place were different from compilers being used in other place, because the features allowed in place X were different from the features allowed in place Y. Because of this reason and the popularity of the language, okay, a proposal was made to develop or to create a standardization of the C programming language. So in 1983, just as you have the Indian Standard Association or the Indian Standard Institute ISI, you have something called as the ANSI, which stands for the American National Standards Institute. So a committee was formed in 1983 to create or to list all the features of C which will be the standard, and it will be required for you to follow the standard so that your code which is developed in, say, Graphicera Deemed, also works in Graphicera Hill as well as works in other places across the world. So if you follow standards, it's said that your code will be able to run anywhere and everywhere which follows that standard. Now in 1989, it took about 4 to 5 years to come up with the standard document. So the American National Standard Institute Committee released the what will be the official or standard version of C in 1989. Then this particular standard was adopted by the International Standard Organization in 1990. So whatever was released by ANSI was accepted by ISO in 1990. So this C89 or C90 refers to the ANSI standards of 89 and the ISO standard of 90, which basically mean the same. Now, C89 or C90, depending on what you decide to call it, got used and a lot of suggestions came in to incorporate changes or to incorporate new standards into the language. So ISO C99 can be considered to be a major improvement or major change over C89 or C90 standard, in the sense additional facilities were provided or additional features were provided in the C language. Examples of those features are something called as inline functions. We will deal with it when we come across variable length arrays and comments on a single line. So these were some of the examples of major changes brought about in C99. Then C11, there were some changes. C18, there was just a revision in the document. So most of our work will basically be on C99 and C11 and C standard. It is important for you to know a little bit about these standards, because when you go outside and work in the industry, you need to be sure on what standard you are working. Because suppose you're working on the 89 standard and you're using a compiler which is based on the C99 or C11 standard, that code may not work because that code may have been, or that feature may have been discontinued later on, or something, some improvement may have been done. So it's very important to understand what version of the compiler you are using when you go to the industry and so on. Not a big deal, you'll easily understand it as you proceed. Now this is the great man Dennis Ritchie, who actually helped develop or created the C language, something which has lived for close to 50 years and probably going to live at least during my lifetime, if not yours. And he has come up with a very beautiful line about programming, and I believe it is very, very true. He says, the only way to learn a programming language is by writing a number of programs in that particular programming language. So I request all of you, as we come to the programming aspect of C, make an effort to write a number of programs on your own. That is going to enhance your understanding, that is going to increase your confidence, and being your first programming language for most of you, it will give you a very solid basis to turn out to develop into a wonderful programmer.